Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Persona 3 Portable. Before we go any further, let's talk a little bit about personas, shall we? This is going to be glorious. It is. And it's only those three at the moment, so. So, first. Yeah, buttons. That as well. Io. You carry his persona. Because I actually did a little bit of research. I was curious. I even think I promised that. But that was in regards of Jungian psychology. That I did not do. In the end, I decided against that. A. Not my field of expertise. B. Not my field of interest. Instead, I choose mythologies. I know I'm an idiot. I'm loving it right now. So, in regards to Io, two things. Number one, mythology. Because those are Zeus. I'm calling it Zeus because I'm filthy German. Zeus. He's basically just over this. He couldn't keep it in his pants again. A lot of troubles after Zeus became king of the Olymp. Came down to he couldn't keep it in his pants. So, Io. So he's in love with this particular woman and decided to kidnap her. We all know that he had ulterior motives. That he couldn't keep it in his pants. So he decided to kidnap her by transforming her into a silver cow. Is he the head the human is hitting on? Chained? Yeah. It's exactly that. So Io was turned into a silver cow by Zeus, so he can later fuck her. But it was found out by his wife Hera, who wasn't amused at all. Is it really that loud? My apologies, but really that loud? Let's go to 5. Yes. And that's too bloody. I'm just glad that I'm not a professional. Oh boy. That's better. So where was I? Yes. He was found out by Hera, who wasn't amused at all, and she decided that maybe it is best to have that particular cow, which she wanted as a present, and he couldn't deny her. Hera thought it may be best if this particular cow is guarded by a giant named Argos, and that particular giant had 100 eyes. That's one image. So, and still, Zeus, still with a desire to dip his dick into Io, he decided to send Hermes, that we'll go later, he sent him to rescue Io and to kill Argos, which he did. This again was found out by Hera, who said, fuck it, you are not doing this shit. I will send an insect, a big one, deadly to cows, to either kill or chase Io. And chase it did. Io ran and ran and ran across the Bosporus until she was in Egypt. At the Nile. It was a long journey. Distance and time. It took this journey to soothe Hera. By the way, Io did not a soothing, I suppose. It was probably Zeus. But it took a while. And all the while, a silver cow was running around with a big-ass insect added to it. And only at the Nile was Hera finally soothed, and Io turned back into a human. Isn't that nice? And all of that because Zeus couldn't keep it in his pants. That's thing number one. Thing number two, which I didn't write down, but luckily it is similar to this little story. It's more, let's say, historic. Apparently, Io was a real person, a princess, princess of Argos, and she was kidnapped. Later on, she was, of course, returned, but you can see the parallels. And apparently this particular kidnapping also started a few other kidnappings back and forth. Targets primarily women. But it was a back and forth between the Greeks and the Phoenicians. That is the correct English word for Phoenicia. I hope so. Then I didn't check. My apologies. But this entire back and forth at one point sparked the Trojan War, which is another thing that is also delightful. Now, next one. No. Hermes. We already know that he killed Argos, the 100-eyed giant, But wait, there's more. Of course, there's more. Luckily, not as much as I thought. But he comes up again later. So, Hannes. God and patron of traffic, merchants, shepherds, thieves, rhetoric, gymnastics, and magic. Also, messenger of the gods, as I repeat myself now, slayer of Argos, and a guide of the dead. And I say a guide because the next one we already saw at the very beginning. And he was at least here pretty pissed. But yeah. The next one is Thanatos, a god of death, son of Nyx and Erebos, Nyx the night, Erebos the darkness, and twin to Hypnos, god of sleep. Thanatos is also at times associated with peaceful death, but also a goddess associated with violent death, going by the name of Keres. And yeah, Thanatos is also a guide of the dead, and he was tricked twice, or multiple times. I think he was also tricked by Hercules. Oh, Hercules. Why did I... Dude, one pronunciation is either Hercules or Hercules. Not Hercules. Don't cross your streams. But the one I'm referring to now, the two times, he was tricked by Sisyphus. You know, the guy who is tasked with rolling a boulder up a mountain just to see it roll down the other side for all of eternity. He's the reason why he was tasked with this. Well, first, he tricked Thanatos to... He was to be chained in the underworld, I think. But he tricked Thanatos to be enchained instead. So Sisyphus could go free, while Thanatos couldn't do his job as a god of death. Which again annoyed another god, the god of war, Ares, because nobody died in his bloody wars, which ticked him off royally. So, Sisyphus was grabbed by Thanatos once again, once Thanatos was freed. But Thanatos was tricked again by Sisyphus saying, "Oh, I can't go, my wife didn't give me the proper funeral, let me see her again so that can happen." And apparently Thanatos, a stickler for etiquette, said, "Fine, have your funeral, your proper funeral, one says, this is our plan. Come back.
Which of course didn't happen.
So, our buddy Hermes had to track Sisyphus back into the underworld, where he is now tasked with rolling a boulder to the top of a mountain just to see it roll down on the other side, and repeating this whole thing eternally. And by the way, the underworld brings us to our next little bit of rambliness. Oops. Buttons. Do you even? No. Details. That was a button. Orpheus. This is a fortunate chain of transitions. I tell you, it wasn't planned. Oy. Said that I didn't have a transition from EO to Hermes, but oh boy. So Orpheus. He was a singer, or rather a bard, or minstrel, and was married to... Oh god. I shall butcher this pronunciation very heavily. Please forgive me, but again, I'm just a filthy German. Oh boy. He was married to Eurydike? A naiad, a nymph. But shortly after, fate saw fit to tear them apart. While playing with her friends, she was bitten by a snake. She didn't see a snake and thus got too close to it and, yeah, was bitten. Shortly after, she died. Orpheus couldn't handle it. So shortly after the marriage, no, he wanted her back. So he made his way into the underworld to plead Hades to give her back. He pleaded and sang, and even the dead wept for him, as did Hades. And so he decided, yes, you can take her back up to the world of the living. Under one condition. On the entire way back, you are not to look back. If you do, I will take her back, and I shall grant, and I won't grant you this mercy again. And our voice agreed. On the way back, on the other hand, he grew nervous and worried, because, let's say, ghosts, and she was a ghost down there, ghosts don't make sounds when they walk. And as the journey went on, he was more nervous and more worried and worried for his love. to the point where he couldn't take it anymore and actually looked back. There she was. With a sad face, slipping back into the underworld. He tried to go back to Hades and plead again. But he wasn't allowed to cross the river again. He was granted this mercy, and he was granted his mercy once, and he accepted. Later on, he went back to the world of the living and grieved and shunned all other women. A few years later, I think it was 2, during the celebration of Dionysus, women came along and heard him grieving and singing. And of course they knew him, for he had shunned all women. And they shouted, "Look, there he is, the one who is mocking us." What did they do? They killed him. Throwing rocks at him. It's sad. Especially since the animals and the other nymphs were still around and made a funeral for him. Clothed him properly. So he could depart into the underworld, where he finally was reunited with his wife. It took a while, and it wasn't the reunion he wished for, but in the end, it is the best he could have hoped for. So, there you go. Oy. Now before I ramble on, let's find the blasted clubs to join. Because that will be done today. After, oh god, almost 24 minutes. Oh, by the way, I checked also this. It doesn't really matter which one I chose, if volleyball or tennis. The social link will be technically the same. The stage will just be different. So, my private playthrough, which I abandoned for this one, I went here, tennis. And the band, it doesn't really matter, just the stage itself changes a little itty bitty tiny bit. So, yeah. You know what? Volleyball, and I'm pressing all the wrong buttons. Girls' volleyball club seems to be using the gym. A note on the door reads, "Girls' volleyball is now seeking new members. Newbies, welcome, come on in." Okay. By the way, I'm pressing all the wrong buttons right now. A, I haven't played this in a month? Actually. And I've played a little bit of Final Fantasy 10, or rather 10-2 HD remaster on my PC. Here, confirm is A. Over there, it's B. So every time I press B, I think, oh, it's confirm. No, no, it isn't. It's cancel here. Ah, isn't it fun? So let's join the volleyball club. Yes, please. Kekkoukan High School Gym. And I need a little bit of orange juice. Oh boy. So you all have a new teammate, yeah! Incoming! She's Shiumi Kotone from Class 2F. Everybody be nice to her, okay? Hello! This club seems to have a rather friendly atmosphere. Yeah! That's always nice. At the very least, it seems that you're welcome here. That's also always nice. Who was the leader for the juniors? Hello, Rio! How's it going? Did I talk to you a tennis girl? I'm good, I leave the rest to you. Don't really know what I'm supposed to do here anyway. And she just resigns and says, alright. Jesus, the teacher's here. Miss Kanu Okano left. I don't really know anything, T. Even the students. Oh, yoy, 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 yoy. Yeah, the ace sounds exactly like her. And what's wrong with acting cute? I guess it's too much. Eh? And yeah, practice. Get your sweater on. Hello. Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays. Yay. Guess what I will do? Dump a lot of time in here. Drive a chariot. You know what? I'll do my best. Yeah. The basics again. Never shun the basics. Never. Without the basics, everything else is just hogwash. If you don't understand the basics, you are not ready for the more advanced stuff. In Yudo, for example, that the basics first are how to flipping fall. If you can't fall properly, you are going to hurt yourself when you are thrown. And we don't want that. So first, the first thing you do, the first thing you learn in Yudo is how to flipping fall. Backwards, sideways, forwards. Later on, even a little bit, it's called free fall. Because that also comes up. And it, by the way, free fall is just a variant of forwards. So, also, backwards, left, right, and with standing up again. Same goes for sidewards. Same goes for forwards. Freefall, also left and right. It's important. And it's not just falling, it's also hitting the mat with your flat hand without trying to flip. Tablet. I need you. I need you right now. Here's the thing with falling. You are not supposed to do a certain thing. Because if you do that, your arms will be in a lot of trouble. Or rather, the joints. Leo. Thank you very much indeed. Don't I have the word in English? You all shall know what I mean. Suffice it to say, it's rather the flat of your hand getting slightly red, or a visit to the hospital. And trust me, a visit to the hospital is not what you want. Come on, come on. You can do it, my little tablet. German word, I mean, by the way, is abstützen. Excuse me. Come on now. Not. I'm fat fingering. Not abstützen! For crying out loud! Not what I want. Once more. This time, with feeling. He says, and go. Okay, I could also use another word. You're not supposed to break the fall with basically putting your arm right on the ground, 90 degrees, won't work, will hurt. This thing I did earlier, basically smashing my hands together, was trying to simulate the actual thing you are supposed to do. At the end, your arm is flat on the ground. You're lying there. Or laying there. And if you're good, Your body will not be hurt. Just maybe your hand is a little bit red and a little bit dingly. Shake the hand a little bit and voila! Everything is nice and easy again. But if you try to break your fall by actually hold up, to prop up your arm, to basically flat hand, 90 degree angle, your joints will hate you for that. Just look up on YouTube, judo falling. And you will quickly see how you're supposed to fall. Hell, you can even look at the Olympics. How they fall during the fights. Which sometimes makes me a little bit cringe, because not cringe. It's sometimes painful to watch. But that's fighting. And yeah, what Rio says. Also, warm up. If you're not warm, you will not have to learn shit. Even if you're just learning falling, and even if the exercises for that seem trivial, there's a reason. Minimizing risk. And trust me, falling is very important. Maybe not so in the beginning, where you're also falling pretty badly. And also be thrown pretty badly. Because you're just starting out. Later on, the techniques get more complicated. To the point where, yeah, you actually have a guy on your shoulders, you are forming a T, and you're throwing it him that way. That's a fun technique, I tell ya. Kataguruma. Fuck that thing. Shoulder int with the groin, crotch, but the general region. Your other shoulder against his chest. Your arm between your right arm between his legs, left arm grabs his arm and pull until you stand. I'm simplifying that technique drastically because you also have to break his balance, footwork. Oh god, I hate that thing. No way. Hate is the wrong word. I despise that thing. Throwing and falling. Because I'm tall, so my partner had to be tall. It was an experience. And I had to learn that thing. I had to learn that thing because it was required to learn. So I am a black belt actually, so I had to learn that thing. Okay, small tangent. The thing I went through to become a black belt was basically something called kata, five groups of three throwing techniques, left and right, and in a specific manner. And in the first group, Katagoruma. Those three groups are also meant to... It's technique, pure technique. But also five groups, and every of these five groups has a different focus. The first group, hand throwing techniques. But what I mean by that, you don't use your legs or hips, arms and hands. You pull. But of course, next was, I believe, hips. Then was legs. The two last groups were sacrificing throwing techniques. Throwing techniques where you either hit the ground with your partner simultaneously or hit the ground before him with this technique. You are sacrificing yourself to get your partner down. So that was one. Oh, hi, chariot. Second, I had to demonstrate other throwing techniques, 15 total. From another section, a very old, let's say, program called Gokyo. The five steps or levels. I had to pick, oh, by the way, every of this five steps or levels had eight throwing techniques. So I had to pick a five within those technique, also hand, hip, leg, to show off that I am a master. That's what black belts are, masters. I had to show that I have mastered hand throwing techniques, hip throwing techniques, leg throwing techniques. So five there. Again with this focus. In this old program, five techniques. And hip leg. Then five different techniques. Left-handed. Again, hand, hip, leg. First five were right-handed, as you, or rather your normal technique. The other five mirrored. The same, the normal throwing technique mirrored. To see, can you do that as well? Have you mastered that as well? After that, five techniques outside of this Gokyo. Which was also fun. And here's the thing, I had to do this part, I had to pick myself. My partner had as well, and a few others in the club. We were three or four at the exam I went to. before that, one or two were taking that exam. So yeah. By the way, that is also just the throwing techniques. Oh hi! Yes, I did. No. We did what we can. What she said. By the way, I'm not done rambling. So, I basically had to quick math, 15 there, technically 30 there, so 45 throwing techniques I had to show. Yeah, 45. 5 times 3 is 15, that times 2 because, yeah, also in the kata, left and right. So, 30. But that's of course not all. Judo is not just throw your opponent to the ground in various ways. It's also holding them down there and choking, and let's say use leverage on their various limbs, predominantly the arms. So let's take it from the top. We were at the throwing techniques. Now there are also certain techniques that transition from, let's say, standing to ground. You can transition certain throwing techniques down to certain grappling techniques on the ground that I had to show. Also, there are also transitions from throwing to choking and from throwing to leverage. Those I also had to show. Then, ground. 4 groups of holding techniques. I had to show them off. Luckily not entirely, but that I could have done easily. Throwing techniques, that was a little bit more sketchy, especially the kata, that was the sketchiest. But ground, transitions, easy peasy. So, 4 groups of holding techniques, varying size. I didn't have to show all of them off. Just, can you do it? Yes, I can. Can you do it from those situations? Yes, I can. Then, again, is the part where the fun starts. Not because, oh, now it's leverage, now it's choking. No. 7 groups of leverage. You can use leverage on an arm while it is stretched out, while it is angled. You can use your own arms for that. Your legs, even your stomach. You can lay there with your partner and across and it's astounding, I tell you. Same goes for choking. There are, okay, there are different types of leverage, as I said, where you use leverage on the angled arm, the stretched arm. You can use your legs, you can use the stomach. And one of the transitions I showed actually was from throwing technique to one of those techniques where you use leverage with your stomach. I think the group's called Harakatana. Hara stomach. And normally Katame is control. But it's neither here nor there right now. Don't quote me on that, by the way. It's been years since I actually practiced. So that is a little bit, you can do it, but don't quote me on that name right now. Now, choking techniques. Now what? Save. Yes, I want to save here. Yes. And almost at an hour. And just because I'm rambling, but let me finish this first. Choking techniques. Again, 7 groups. Again, hands, legs. And that is also choking techniques are the last things you learn. First, you learn throwing techniques, grappling techniques on the ground. Next step there, leverage. After that, the transitions. And very late, I think it is around blue or brown, but very late, choking techniques. Reason being, if you do something wrong, it's devastating. Again, it's choking. Not just you throwing your partner bad and he falling bad, so, which is still bad, or doing the leverage techniques, going a bit too fast and you hear crack? No. Choking techniques are the most dangerous. Because you are actually cutting off air and or blood to the brain. Again, choking. That's the entire point of choking. So, you learn that very late. When you have come to a certain age and have shown that, yes, you are responsible by actually having those belts, blue and brown. You know your partner or partners. You know the people in your club, you trust each other. And if you signal stop by either clapping on his or her back or by saying Maita, your partner has to stop. They can't just choke
even further when you do that. Because there's a serious risk of death there. So, again, you can choke with your arms, your legs, not with your stomach. Well, technically, you can just press the head against the stomach and see how that goes. But it's not a technique. Arms and legs. Now, there are also three different kinds of choking techniques, not just divided by arms, how what you use, but also how you choke. Do you just cut off the air, or do you cut off air and blood, or just blood? That is possible. There are blood vessels going up your neck. And generally, your neck is the slimmest part of you. Genitals not including. And guess what is on your neck? Your skull. And what is in your skull? Your brain. Air chokers, pretty easy to explain. It's just you're cutting the airflow off. Air and blood chokers, that is more. Let's make sure that everything is cut off. Those two are pretty, I say, safe, despite knowing those are choking techniques with a certain risk attached, but because both also cut off, or only cut off air, your partner will at one point say, "Okay, enough. Please give me oxygen." Either by way of signaling you with clapping or mitre. The third kind, blood choking techniques. Those are the most dangerous because you are not cutting off air supply. Your partner can still breathe, but you are cutting off the blood flow to the brain. That is completely different. The hair comes also. Those also bear the most responsibility, or impose the most responsibility on both you and your partner. If you're using them, you A, make certain that, of course, the technique is correct, but also look in the face of your partner and see if anything changes, if he or she gets paler. If they do, stop immediately. I had a partner which I trained these, and he was a fighter. So giving up wasn't really in his vocabulary. Because he went to a few tournaments, one, so on and so forth. So he had a certain behavior trained into him.
Luckily, those blood sugars are, as far as I know, not prominent. Tournaments, at least here in Germany. I don't know internationally. There they probably are. But look in the face of your partner. If he or she doesn't signal you, stop. But gets paler and paler, stop. Otherwise, you have a world of trouble in front of you. And with that, I probably made this whole sport very tasty to a certain kind of people. But I also had to show those off. It's a lot. Later on, at least here in Germany, they decide, okay, let's loosen it up. Okay, fine. Slightly annoying, but okay. Then they decide to loosen up even further. Everybody thought, what the fuck? And here's the thing. I screwed up at my exam. The throwing techniques. I was nervous as hell. Especially during the kata, I jumbled it completely. Messed up entire groups. But apparently it was still good enough. In that part that they decided, okay. He is a master, he mastered the techniques. We just shouldn't touch him right now, because if we do, he probably jumps through the roof. Because I was a nervous wreck. Mostly during the throwing technique exam. Later down, transition, and then the ground techniques. Beautiful. But yeah. Fun. Let's finish this day. And I'm pressing still all the wrong buttons. Ah yeah, you were injured. Yeah. Yeah, a little bit of sport. It's thrice a week, which is slightly annoying. I had judo twice a week in the evenings. So, thrice. Shadows. And yes, this. It's on purpose. Yeah, I know. Yes, you do. Our personas are just a manifestation of them. So, but yeah, it's combat. Yeah. By the way, I do not know why Junpei has Hermes as a persona. I seriously can't figure that one out. I seriously can't. Special effects, oh, this is still all tutorial information. Yeah, Mitsu, how's it going? Yeah. I think that is actually what I shall do. You will recover within a few days of your rest and do not go to Tartarus. Be aware of your condition. If you are sick or tired, you will not fight at full strength during battle. I know. So what does the TV say? You turned on the television. Despite this, they were able to safely finish the concert. The next story is about a strange animal from overseas. It's called the platypus. The platypus, an animal native to Australia, is an egg-laying mammal. And behind the male platypus' feet are poisonous spurs. What a strange animal indeed. Go to our room. Yes, please, we are not going out today. Don't know what to do. Let's go to bed. Simply go to bed, yes. New moon. You overhear conversation. Oh hey, you know the bookstore at the strip mall? Isn't there grand reopening today? Oh yes, another social link. Another bookstore? Yeah, leave Eva today's station, blah 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 blah. Early morning after school. Class has ended for today. Yes. Safe. And I will see you next time. Good night and sleep well.